would be starting a new series where I'm going to talk about RuPaul's Drag Race. So recently I decided to rewatch every single episode because I've already seen every single episode. Give or take a few episodes, because I know a few of them I haven't been able to find, but I decided to do a recap after I watch every episode, because I think that would kind of be fun, just to kind of talk about what I saw. And I decided that, to keep in the spirit, I'd wear one of my wigs for each episode. I don't have enough to do a different wig for every episode, so there'll be some repeats, but I thought this would just be a little fun thing to do. So, I'm almost done with episode 2, so I'm gonna start with episode 1, the one that I watched last night of season 1. Sorry about that, that was my bed creaking. And I'm just doing these on my phone. Queens. I can't remember the order that the queens came into the competition, but I have this list right here. It's not in order of elimination or anything, so I'm not spoiling anything, so it should be safe. But I'm going to announce, or I'm going to say the name of the queen and kind of give my first thoughts, what I thought of them. So first, again, I don't know if this is the first queen to walk in, but I believe this was the first queen, Victoria Porkchop Parker. Apparently she's been doing this a very long time, and it was very strange to see her then compared to how she looks now, because she was just unbotched, so she got a brand new nose and everything. So it was really weird to see her back then compared to now. It's been a drastic change. Queen to come in was Angina. I thought her little entrance bit was funny. I really appreciate what Angina does. The fact that she doesn't wear hair, it's something different in the drag community. Especially for 2009, I think that's when this season, it was either 2008 or 2009 that this season aired, but that was something really not heard of as much. Bald queens weren't really a thing, but I'm excited to see what else she brings, because I can't say that I remember a lot of season 1, because it's very hard to find links to these things, but I finally found one, so I'm glad. The next one to walk in was Bibi Zahara Benet. She is from Cameroon. I think it said that she now lives in Minneapolis. I'm not sure how to say it exactly, but she's from there. It's in Minnesota, I think. I love what she does. I love what I saw from the episode. I think that, well, I know how she does, so I'm not going to spoil it, but from what I saw, I think that she's going to do pretty well. She just has a very genuine personality, it seems. Next queen we're talking about is Rebecca Glasscock. Her name just makes me laugh every single time. Her entrance outfit, it looked like she was going to the mall or coming back from the mall, especially for 2009, and you're going to be on national television and you're going to wear that. If you're not sure what I'm talking about, it's very hard to find a picture, but if you ever see what I'm talking about, you'll know what I mean. But I don't know. what I saw, I'm not very impressed by. I'm sorry, I'm just not. I don't even know if Rebecca does drag anymore. I hope she does. Because, okay, when I say I wasn't impressed, I think by now her style would have changed a lot. I also just realized I look like Weird Al Yankovic, or whatever his name is. Or whatever. Oh, I'm sorry. Next queen is Chanel. I love Chanel. Oh my god, I love what Chanel does. I just love how Chanel is just like so oblivious to everything, and I don't know, I think it comes off very genuine, and she's just like, she's kind of shady, but she owns that and makes it work. From what I saw, her outfit was very, I know what kind of queen Chanel is. She's definitely a Vegas queen, and what she serves is very Vegas and showgirl-esque, so I figured I'll see a lot of outfits like that, like a lot of headdresses and all that. But I was impressed by her, and I'm gonna enjoy seeing all of her outfits again. The next queen is Nina Flowers. I absolutely love Nina Flowers. I love what she does. I love what she did back then, and I love what she does now. She's just one of the most talented queens I've ever seen. She also does some bald looks, where it'll be like a loaf of hair on the top of the head, which I think is cool. Just tattoos everywhere, just very intricate, very painterly. Her makeup is just like very precise and very, like, she paved the way for a lot of RuPaul queens. Like, I'm sure a lot of people were watching the season one when it came out and were like, wow, I'm going to try some new avant-garde things with my makeup and see how it goes. So I'm glad that Nina Flowers was casted, because she just really introduced something new and exciting for us. The next queen we'll talk about, Tammy Brown, is literally insane. I love her though. When I first started drag, I was really inspired by Tammy, because a lot of people say that mine and Tammy Brown's personalities are very similar, which I can see. People say that I'm very eccentric, and sometimes the things I say don't make sense, and I think that's hilarious. But yeah, Tammy's looks are very fun, very different for what you would see at the time for a drag queen. Not many people like had the like 40s aesthetic to go to. Did they? I don't know. I'm not gonna lie, I'm only 20, so I wasn't like, I didn't even know what drag was in 2009. I was only like, how old? I was only like in sixth grade, I think. So I would have been in sixth grade when season one came out, but we didn't have like the logo channel, so like I could never watch it. I didn't even really know what, like, had never heard of drag queens or like anything like that, because I live in the middle of nowhere and I'm not really exposed to that kind of stuff. But yeah, Tammy, love her. Think she's a really talented queen. I love what she does and everything. The next queen is Jade. Jade's from Chicago, so hometown-ish. I live like an hour away from Chicago, so like when I say a home queen, it's usually someone from Chicago, because it's the closest big city. But she was cool. I don't really remember what she wore for this challenge, but her personality is seeming to shine through, so that's good. And Akasha, I'm not sure how to say it exactly. She's coming off a bit arrogant. I'm not sure if she, I think she still does drag, but I don't know, just, I don't know, I don't know off the show just didn't really paint her in a good light, or she's doing this herself. I'm not quite sure. I think she needs an attitude adjustment before something gets out of hand. I'm sure when you put too many drag queens in a room, it just gets very catty, especially when someone has a bad personality. So yeah, that's something to watch out for. And I haven't really been excited by her outfits lately at all. I've only seen like two of them, and they're just not anything spectacular, but I know back then it was something, like the dynamic was really different. I don't know if dynamic is the right word, but what I mean is like, fashion was different. Drag queen fashion was very different back then. And like especially if like a queen were to, they wouldn't even allow a queen to walk into the workroom wearing jeans and like a t-shirt, not a t-shirt, but Rebecca was wearing jeans and like this yellow cutoff top, and that would not be allowed. Like the level of what you're supposed to be at has changed so much. Because it's a very competitive environment. Because it's a competition, duh, but like even drag has changed and it's very competitive. And it's something you really have to work hard at. It's not. It's hard, it really is. It's very expensive and very time consuming. So, but anyway, their first mini challenge was a car photo shoot with Mike Ruiz. And they had to pose in front of a car wash scene, and whoever had like the sexiest, most alluring photo won. And I believe, the winner was Nina Flowers. Her photo, she just really like captured the essence of it. The whole like, she's just so striking. She's very striking, so I can see why she would win that. I can't remember what she won. I don't know. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I don't think Nina won the mini challenge. I'm sorry, I just kind of gave it away. I don't know if Nina won the mini challenge, but I don't know if she did or not. But what I meant when I'm reading is Nina was the main challenge winner. I remember that now, but the main challenge was to make an outfit out of thrift store items and dollar store items. So it really tested the queen's ability to build an outfit and create a wearable piece that represented them, but was also showing their like crafty side. So Nina won that. She was wearing something very edgy and very androgynous. Like it wasn't like typical drag queen fashion. She had like on a jacket. It was really different, and it was really cool. It was. I really liked it. I loved everyone's outfits. I think everyone's kind of was just like, it was a very cool first ever challenge. So I was really impressed. And the two queens that were, the way, if you've never seen RuPaul's Drag Race, the way it's a competition that you are tested on, like, all areas that drag queens should be kind of knowledgeable in. And since what we do is usually, I'll see if I can cut that part out. My Skype just went off, so this wig is so itchy. Maybe I can make some sounds. It's just because there's no like lace. I don't know. That was probably weird. I'm sorry. But the two queens that were in the bottom were Akasha and Victoria Porkchop Parker. Their outfits were my favorites. host of the show, RuPaul's song. I think it was Supermodel of the World. Well, Supermodel, you better work. And sadly, the one who was sent home was Victoria, and that was just a really big shock because, she was expected to stay. And it's just, everyone was really surprised when she left because she was such a seasoned queen that everyone thought she would be doing a lot better. But, you know, sometimes those competitions just kind of, you never know how it's gonna be, because sometimes you might get tripped up on one aspect and then that's just the end of it. So I know, like, for a lot of seasons I thought queens were gonna do well pre-season. Then I see them on the show and I'm like, wow, better in a challenge later on in the season, but they just didn't get that chance. It's just the name of the game, I guess. But I think that's where I'm gonna end this episode. I don't even know what to call these. Just kind of like a get, let's just listen to me talk about my favorite thing in the world. But thank you for listening. Hopefully this relaxed you. And if you have never seen RuPaul's Drag Race, it's very hard to find the first season. It's known as the lost season because it was kind of, I don't know if they wanted it erased from existence, but they've really, really tried. But yeah, go check it out. It's a great show. Love it. Inspired me to do drag. And I think that's it for now. I'll see you all in the next episode.